we have this just in. The Philippine National Telecommunications Commission is ordering ABS-CBN, its radio stations DZMM and MOR, to stop broadcasting operations. And this after the media giant's franchise expired on Monday, May 4th. Earlier, Philippine lawmakers said they see no reason why ABS-CBN Corporation cannot continue operating even without a provisional authority from the National Telecommunications Commission. The House Committee on Legislative Franchises Chair, Franz Chicoy Alvarez, says Congress has the exclusive authority to deny or extend broadcast franchises. Agusan Representative Lawrence Fortun, meanwhile, is calling on the Office of the Solicitor General to set aside its legal row with ABS-CBN as the Philippines deals with COVID-19. Senator Sonny Angara notes that Solicitor General Jose Calida contradicts the Justice Secretary when he told the NTC that it was in no position to grant ABS-CBN a provisional authority to operate. Philippine Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara had said there is a basis to allow ABS-CBN's operations while the bills for its franchise renewal are pending in Congress. We'll be speaking now to Laguna 3rd District Representative Saul Aragones about this issue. Congresswoman Saul, magandang hapon sa inyo.
Magandang hapon, Tony, at magandang hapon po sa lahat ng inyong taga-panood.
Nakinita nyo ba o inaasahan nyo ba na ganito ang magiging desisyon ng NTC gayong nung mga nakaraang hearing, lalo na sa Senado, ay parang nabanggit naman ng NTC, DOJ, na wala namang hadlang para bigyan ng provisional authority ang ABS-CBN na magpatuloy muna?
Tony, ito ay ikinagulat natin at ikinadismaya dahil ang inaasahan ko sana na ilalabas ngayon ng NTC ay ang provisional authority para magpatuloy ng pag-ere ang ABS-CBN habang ito nga ay dinidinig sa Kongreso, pero kabalik talaga nito ang lumabas ngayon. Bakit? Kasi sa natatandaan ko, nung March 10 kung saan nagkaroon ng hearing ang Committee on Franchise at isa ang NTC sa mga naging resource speakers doon, naitanong nga natin yung paglabas o pag-issue nila nitong provisional authority para sa ABS-CBN. At ito ay inasahan natin dahil ito ay napag-usapan nung oras na yon. So ang hinihintay natin, ilalabas na lamang nila ngayon. Hindi lang natin maunawaan kung bakit iba ang inilabas at hindi ito. Gayong mismong ang chairman ng Committee on Franchise ay sa isa natin at si Speaker sa paniniwala na kung ang House of Representatives nga ay may kapangyarihan para magbigay ng franchise sa isang institusyon, ito pa ba provisional authority ang hindi pwedeng saklaw ng kapangyarihan ng Kongreso?
So, sa ganitong aspeto na kailangan pa mag-schedule ng mga hearings sa Kongreso para dinggin nga itong mga panukala para mabigyan ng panibagong prangkisa ang ABS-CBN, hindi kaya nagiging mas imperative, no, para sa House na bilisan na yung proseso? Ano pa ba ang kailangan gawin nito?
Actually, nabanggit naman ni Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano na ito naman ay magkakaroon ng schedule para dito. Dangan nga lamang at nagkaroon nga nitong COVID-19. Pero balikan ko lang, Tony, yung kwento ng NTC na ang sa atin nga, sinabi ni Speaker at ng Committee on Franchise, mag-hearing naman kami dito, mag-schedule kami. Kundi nga lang nagkaroon ng COVID-19, ang sa atin lang, sana ang pinag-usapan noong March 10 ay sana ay inonor at sana ay ang nailabas ngayong araw na ito, yung provisional authority nga na magpatuloy pa sa ere itong ABS. Hindi lang ako nagulat dito, marami kami nagulat na bakit ito yung lumabas ngayong araw na ito.
Sa palagay po ba ninyo, Congresswoman Saul, may kinalaman ito doon sa naging banta ni Solicitor General Jose Calida na maaaring kasuhan ang sinumang kawani ng DOJ o ng NTC na magbibigay nitong provisional authority dahil sa kanyang tinutukoy na Saul authority na pagbibigay nga nitong siguro yung to broadcast ano ay nasa Kongreso at hindi dapat ito nang gagaling sa NTC mismo o sa DOJ. At sabi nga niya, kung meron bang kumilos laban sa ganitong provision ng konstitusyon, ay maaaring kasuhan.
As of now, Tony, I can't speculate, pero nakinig ko kasi kahapon yung sinabi ni spokesperson Harry Roque sa ang sinasabi niya ay ang Malacanang, ang pagtingin dito, ay kung ano yung sasabihin ng NTC ay gagalang nila. At ang inusahan nga natin, babalik ulit ako doon sa pinag-usapan no March 10 na ang ilalabas talaga ay ito. No? So tingnan natin kung ano ang magiging sunod na hakbang ng Kongreso dito dahil hindi pa kami, dahil nagulat nga rin na ako dito. Tingnan natin, magtatawag din tayo, alamin natin kung anong sunod na hakbang ng Kongreso dito, kung bakit hindi in-honor ang pinag-usapan sa Committee on Franchises noong March 10 sa pagbibigay ng provisional authority sa ABS-CBN.
Mm. At ang direktiba ng NTC, Congresswoman, ano, na sinasabi ay bibigyan ng 10 araw na parang palugit itong ABS-CBN matapos nga natanggapin itong cease and desist order na magbigay ng kanyang paliwanag kung bakit hindi daw dapat bawiin yung mga frequencies na nakalaan dito. No? So habang hinihintay pa ho ba yung 10 days na makasagot ang ABS-CBN sa direktibang ito, ay maaaring may gawin na ang Kongreso para solusyonan ito?
Sa ngayon ay aalamin muna natin sa House of Representatives kung anong sunod na gagawin at mag-a-update tayo kung anong ating mapapag-usapan sa susunod na hakbang dito, Tony.
Mm-hmm. Meron po ba kayong nakakausap, Congresswoman Sol, sa mga katuwang ninyo sa Senado? Kung paano po nyo maaaring mapabilis ang proseso ng pagdidinig dito sa mga franchise proposals?
Sa ngayon, nakita naman natin kung maghiwalay kasi. So sa House, ito yung mga nakakausap natin. At ito nga, isa rin yung stand nung ibang nakakausap natin na kumbaga ay ang Senado ay kumikilos bilang isang institusyon at kami rin ay kumikilos bilang isang institusyon. Pero ang maganda nun, Tony, kung makikita mo, isa dulo talagang iisa eh. Iisa yung paniniwala namin ng Senado at ng Kongreso na dapat maglabas ng provisional authority kasi during the hearing last March 10, may nag-cite pa nga eh. Nag-cite pa ng mga example ng mga institusyon na dati na dinidinig habang dinidinig ay naglabas ng provisional authority ang NTC. Kung nagawa noon, bakit hindi pwede gawin ngayon?
Kumbaga, ang tawag nila doon ay may precedent no? Na maaaring gawing batayan ng NTC para makapagbigay ng provisional authority. Hindi naman siyempre lingid sa kaalaman ng ating mga manonood at na tagapakinig na kayo ay dating kapamilya na nagtrabaho din mismo dito sa ABS-CBN ng ilang taon. Ano ang mensahe mo sa inyong mga dating kasama sa trabaho?
Nako, ano ba ito? Magiging emotional na naman tayo nito. Ako kasi, Tony, may COVID-19. Maraming tao ang kailangan ng trabaho. Kung mawawala ang ABS-CBN, mas madadagdagan pa ang mga tao na mawawala ng trabaho. So yung panawagan natin sa NTC, tingnan din ho natin yung kapakanan ng bansa natin ngayon. Marami nang walang trabaho. Yung mga taga-ABS-CBN, umaasa ho sila dito na pagkatapos ng araw ng May 4 kahapon, ay lalabas na ng NTC ang provisional authority para may pagpatuloy nilang kanilang buhay at magkaroon ng
ng maayos na buhay ang kanina mga pamilya. Pasensya ka na, Tony, nag-emotional ako. Alam mo naman, 13 years ako nagtrabaho sa ABS-CBN. Minsan din akong nagtrabaho dyan at alam ko ang pakiramdam ng isang empleyado. At kaya talagang medyo very emotional ako dito sa franchise ng ABS. Pero umaasa pa rin ako at kumakapit pa rin ako doon sa pag-asa na maibibigay pa rin ito sa ABS-CBN para na lang po sa 11,000 na mga empleyado na umaasa na yung kanilang mga anak ay mga kapag-aral at may kakainin pa sila sa kinabukasan dahil may trabaho pa sila na may bibigay galing sa ABS-CBN.
Congressman Saul, maraming salamat na binigyan niyo kami ng oras. Oo, at umaasa kami na sakasakali ay maririnig din naman natin kung ano ang saloobin ng liderato ng Kamara at ng Senado tungkol sa usaping ito. Congressman Saul Aragonas, the 3rd District of Laguna, maraming salamat sa iyo, Congressman Saul.
Maraming salamat.
Albay 2nd District Representative Joy Salceda also joins us on the line to give us his reaction to the cease and desist order of the NTC against ABS-CBN Corporation. Congressman Salceda, magandang hapon sa inyo. Congressman? All right, we'll call on Congressman Salceda again. If you can hear me, Congressman Salceda? All right, we've lost the connection to Albay Congressman Joy Salceda. Nikki? Of course, today, most people were looking forward to the lifting of the enhanced community quarantine for Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon. And the ABS-CBN Corporation, as well as other media outlets, such as this news channel, has been trying to give you, of course, all the relevant and timely information that our citizenry will depend on to be able to keep themselves safe while they're under lockdown. And hopefully, even though the NTC order might be effective immediately, that we will still be able to give you more information through this ABS-CBN news channel and, of course, through our online news portals. We've been, of course, awaiting the decision of the National Telecommunications Commission before May 4th yesterday, and we were of course hoping that the NTC would grant that provisional authority for ABS-CBN to operate. Meanwhile, Surigao del Sur 2nd District Representative Johnny Pimentel is supposed to join us now on the line. All right, I think we have can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can hear you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir, and thank you for joining us. Has this decision somehow, for you, been well thought of? I mean, considering that previous hearings in Congress already put forth the opinion that a provisional authority to operate is in fact not unique, that it could be granted to other broadcast institutions who were still having their franchises deliberated on in Congress, why couldn't it apply to ABS-CBN now?
Yes, that's to say, I was really surprised when NTC issued a cease and desist order, because it has already happened before, where in some of the franchises were expired, but they were allowed to operate. Now, take for the case of the CBCP franchise. Nag-expire na yung franchise nila, but they were allowed to operate.
Mm-hmm.
Take the case of Smart and also of PNP. So why single out ABS-CBN? Mm-hmm. And if you recall, before the recess of Congress, the Senate already passed a resolution in joining NTC to issue a provisional authority.
Mm-hmm.
And in Congress, right after the hearing, if you recall, that was on March 11, I believe, Speaker Cayetano and together with our chairman, Franz Alvarez, wrote a letter to NTC again expressing their sentiment that NTC should should issue a provisional authority. Mm. But I believe this is an offshoot, itong cease and desist order of the pronouncement or the statement of the OSG Kalida. Mm. Because andun sa statement niya, meron siyang said doon that it will file a case for those who will issue a provisional authority. Siguro that was one of the reason or the main reason why ENTC issued the desist order. I believe that today is a very sad day for us Filipinos because ABS-CBN has been in the forefront of disseminating information with regard to this pandemic. Sana naman dapat hindi nila denying na ngayon sila mag-cease and desist order. I mean, let us set aside politics. Unahin na muna natin ito. Ako mismo, I get information on a day-to-day basis from ABS-CBN on their day-to-daily blow-by-blow account of what is happening, especially with the government updates. And then, aside from that, we have seen that ABS-CBN is doing its part in helping our constituents. If I'm not mistaken, through Pagtawid ng Pag-ibig, you have already released 300 million pesos. Sana naman, pinatapos na muna natin itong crisis bago ilabas yung cease and desist order. We have so many problems already that we should face another problem, itong franchise. Bakit single out ABS-CBN? It has already, it was done before. There were so many franchises that were allowed to operate without even the expiration of their franchise. Eh, bakit itong ABS-CBN hindi naman pagbigyan?
Congressman Johnny, pasensya na po. Ano, matanong ko lang. Kapag po ba naglabas kunwari ng opinion na ganito at yung Office of the Solicitor General, may kasama pa pong banta ito, no? Maaari daw nilang kasuhan kung sino mang kawanin ng DOJ at NTC na magbigay ng provisional authority. Sa palagay po ba ninyo, kung merong kalabisan, di umano, yung ganitong mga pagbabanta ng Office of the Solicitor General, ay meron din po bang magiging parang appropriate sanction sa kanya kapag kunwari lumabas na he was actually exceeding the authority given to him at hindi niya na-recognize yung authority ng NTC na magbigay ng provisional authority?
Yes, I think so. Well, depende na yan because OSG is under, of course, the executive department. No? So, of course, we already know very well that whatever sanction will be given will also be coming from the chief executive. But I believe that the opinion of the OSG is not proper at this point in time because there were threats. Pwede naman yung sabihin na, based on some legalities that NTC cannot issue. Eh, bakit lalagyan pa niya doon ng threat that if ever na mag-issue kayo, ipapailan ko pa kayo ng kaso. Mukhang pinipersonal na niyang ABS-CBN on that note, hindi po ba? Dapat if you will release a statement, you will base it on legal opinion or legalities. Eh bakit may threat pa doon na kung pag if you will issue a provisional order, I will file a case of you against you. So I believe this is the main reason why NTC issued this cease and desist order kasi ayaw nilang mapailan sila ng kaso, especially coming from the OSG, wherein NTC also part of the executive department.
Congressman Johnny, ano, balikan natin yung nakaraang hearing na sa Senado at sa Kongreso na na-raise din po yung mga akusasyon ni Solicitor General Kalida kontra sa ABS-CBN. Meron pong yung mga sinasabi niya na hindi nakapagbayad ng buwis. Meron yung pag-ooperate daw ng pay-per-view na hindi otorisado. Lahat po yan sinagot na rin po punto por punto ng mga ehekutibo ng ABS-CBN sa Kamara at sa Senado. At tinanggap naman po yung sagot din po ng mga opisyal ng ABS-CBN na pawang tama naman yung naging depensa laban sa mga akusasyong ito. Sa palagay niyo po ba, sa ngayon, yung mga akusasyong yun ay kailangan pa rin bigyan ng halaga ng NTC? Gayong pabulaanan naman ang mga ito ng sapat na paliwanag dun sa mga hearing ng Kamara at ng Senado?
Actually, kataka-taka talaga yung decision ng NTC ngayon because if you recall, during the hearing, of the ABS-CBN last March 11, I was there, I attended. And in fact, I asked the question dun sa NTC, so based on the DOJ opinion, will you issue provisional authority? And they said yes. Then all of a sudden, ngayon, about face sila, all of a sudden. So along the way, something really pushed the decision to issue this order. At saka sabi ko nga, mukhang pinipersonal na ni OSG Kalida ang ABS-CBN ito. Kasi dati pa nga, sabi ko, meron namang in-issue na expire na ng mga franchise. Why they were allowed? There was already in short a precedent. Meron ng precedent na inallow ng NTC mag-operate yung ibang franchise
Opo.
Na expired. E bakit itong ABS-CBN hindi inallow? Yun ang tanong ko. And I think I don't know the reason why OSD Kalida is meddling into this franchise when in fact it is the authority or power of Congress to grant, to revoke any franchise. Bakit na pinapakalaman ng trabaho ng Kongreso? Sana pinabayaan na lang ito. Mukhang, pero I believe that Ulysses Kalita is a personal thing with ABS-CBN. Siya, even the president, sabi nga ng presidente, let the Congress decide with regards to the fate of ABS-CBN.
Congressman Johnny, no, panghuling pagkakataon na lang po bago po tayo magwakas, meron po ba kayong gustong mensaheng ipaabot kay Sol Jen Kalita?
Eh, na akin lang naman na, Tony, sana naman na pagbigyan naman muna niya ang ABS-CBN ngayon. We already resumed our session, and you know that very soon this hearing could continue with regards to the renewal of ABS-CBN. Pagbigyan na muna niya kasi nasa problema tayo ngayon, nasa crisis tayo ngayon. Let us set aside politics and let us be sober about it. Let us, huwag natin personal ito because maraming at stake dyan sa ABS-CBN aside from the people who are working with ABS-CBN. ABS-CBN is already part of the Filipino lives.
All right. Congressman Johnny Pimentel, a representative of Surigao del Sur, 2nd District. Thank you very much, sir, for speaking with us today. And we'll be bringing into our discussion Verhel Santos, a Board of Trustee of the Center for Media Freedom and Responsibility. Verhel, good afternoon to you, and how are you doing?
Yeah. Sorry to hear about this.
Mm-hmm. So, we've spoken to two members of the House already, Congresswoman Sol Aragones, Congressman Johnny Pimentel, both of them expressing, of course, that they were taken by surprise by this development, given that in a previous hearing in March, the NTC had already, in a way, expressed its favorable opinion on granting a provisional authority for ABS-CBN. Is there any conceivable scenario for you on why the NTC could have changed its mind?
Congress should quickly respond to this because this is an affront on Congress. It's a preemptive action against Congress by NTC, which is simply a technical manager. It does not give franchises and it does not take away franchises. The problem is if the NTC felt it had the power to do this, it would have done that a long time ago. Apparently, NTC has been prevailed upon to do this at this time. And why at this time? I can see, because I've been watching ABS-CBN, I can see that ABS-CBN has been stepping up in the face of this pandemic. And part of that intensified role is the revelation of certain government shortcomings in its efforts to make life easier for the nation in the face of this emergency. So I can only explain it in that way. Also, I have noticed a tendency to seize this occasion, as a distraction and to do some truly high-handed thing. You know, for instance, we all know that the lead agencies that are dealing with this pandemic are all led by former general. You can see that even IATF is loaded with probably about nine or ten generals. This is military domination, and you can see that the streets are crawling with police and troops, and even trucks mounted with machine guns. Now, this should not be lost on people. The problem is, what can we do? We are quarantined. All of us are quarantined. We can't even go out there in the street and speak our protest. You know, this is so worrisome, Tony. This is, to me, very worrisome. Why it should happen at this time?
Mm.
And so far as I can gather, it was Mr. Kalida again who started this effort.
Mm.
I cannot quite understand it. Of course, this is something else. The constitutional point is, again, simply that NTC cannot do this.
Mm.
In fact, my thinking is that once you have given such freedom by franchise to a media organization, you cannot take that away. You cannot take that away, because that will be in violation of the constitutional prohibition against encroaching upon certain freedoms.
Mm.
That's another matter. But the height of inconsiderateness is that nangyari ito ngayon habang naka-lockdown tayo pare-pareho. No? Ba't hindi nakaantay? O kaya bakit hindi maaga pa, even before coronavirus struck?
Hmm.
Bakit hindi pa noon? I think Congress had better respond very quickly to this.
Hmm.
Because this does not bode well for our freedom. What is happening today? It is not just ABS-CBN. You know, ABS-CBN has been stepping up very admirably in the face of this pandemic. And now you are being closed. Why?
Do you think, Verhel, that Congress can actually act speedily to overturn this latest?
I think Congress should.
Yeah.
I think these people had better start calling you and start calling one another and start getting together in whatever way, Zoom or whatever, and make these people understand that this cannot happen, that you cannot do this, not only to ABS-CBN, but to Congress.
Mm.
NTC alone, NTC is doing this to Congress.
Mm.
And apparently, the dictates of the Office of the Solicitor General.
Hmm.
I mean, this is clear enough. I mean, there is nothing so subtle about this, Tony.
Hmm.
Wala namang mahirap intindihin dito eh.
But you know, but the office of the Solicitor General still has another, approach to try to deprive ABS-CBN of a new franchise, and that's the Quaranto case. That's still pending at the Supreme Court. At the same time that you're urging Congress, both houses of Congress, to act speedily and resolve this issue, do you think the Supreme Court can also act speedily on resolving the Quaranto case?
No, I think the Supreme Court should wait. I think the Supreme Court should wait.
Hmm.
I think the Supreme Court would be going along with Mr. Khalid and NTC if it decided to do whatever it might be, whatever it might decide to do during this emergency. I cannot understand why this should be a greater emergency than what we are having now.
Mm.
I cannot understand this. I think the Supreme Court should simply stay put. But it's Congress. It's Congress that has been affronted by NTC.
Mm.
NTC is nothing more than a franchise manager, a technical manager. You know?
Yeah. All right, Verhel, we'd like to thank you for giving us, of course, your take on this issue. As you did say, you know, we're still under quarantine, and you know, people can't express their sentiments out on the streets on this issue.
But we do
appreciate.
I would have been there. I would have been there for you.
Yeah, we do appreciate your support for us, Verhel, and of course to everybody there at the Center for Media Freedom and Responsibility.
Yeah.
Thank you for speaking with us.
This is about freedom. It's about freedom.
Thank you, Verhel. Yeah. Thank you.
Well,
the matter of allowing ABS-CBN to operate after the cease and desist order, now in the hands of the House of Representatives, that's according to Senator Bongo, who says he will wait for the lower house's move before he makes his own decision. The militant group Bayan, meanwhile, slams the NTC for issuing the order during this health crisis. It also calls the order a serious threat to press freedom.
For Philippine Senate Majority Leader Mig Zubiri, the NTC's order is highly irregular. He questions why the agency can't just issue a provisional authority when there are many other stations operating on one. Senator Risa Ontiveros agrees. She says nothing should have prevented the NTC from issuing the provisional authority. As for Senator Sonny Angara, he calls the move disappointing. He says this is not the time to shut down a source of reliable information. There is no reason for ABS-CBN to discontinue or stop their operations until we make a final decision. That's according to Representative Franz Chicoy Alvarez, chair of the House Committee on Legislative Franchises. Alvarez earlier addressed the news that the Solicitor General made efforts to pressure the National Telecommunications Commission to go against the ruling of the Department of Justice, which states that ABS-CBN may continue to broadcast while Congress deliberates on the renewal of its franchise. Alvarez said such actions, quote, directly challenges the lower chamber's exclusive constitutional authority to grant, deny, extend, revoke, or modify broadcast franchises. He maintains because the House already begun the deliberations on ABS-CBN's franchise renewal in March, the House committee will not be dictated upon by any individual or agency as to the manner, schedule, and conduct of its official business.
Senate Minority Leader, Franklin Drilon, joins us now on the line to share his take on this issue. Senator Drilon, good afternoon to you, sir.
Tony, good afternoon. Nikki, good afternoon.
Yeah.
Well,
Senator Drilon, we were there at a very lengthy, hearing of the Senate chaired by Senator Grace Poe, and of course the heard the explanations given by ABS-CBN executives on the supposed violations of ABS-CBN. Now, during that hearing, the NTC was also asked whether or not it could issue a provisional authority to ABS-CBN. And now it seems that they took a different tack on this issue. What do you feel happened in between?
Well, I don't know, but what is clear is that the NTC gravely abused its discretion in ordering the in issuing the cease and desist order. Yes, during that hearing, even the Secretary of Justice said the ABS-CBN can continue, a provisional authority can be issued on the basis of precedents issued, precedents in the Supreme Court, wherein it was ruled that so long as the application is pending in Congress, the provisional authority can be issued, and that has been the rule followed in Congress. So it is quite unfortunate, and I do not understand why this happened. And at this time, when the public needs information about the pandemic, number two, at this time when hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of workers are laid off temporarily or permanently, the livelihood of 11,000 workers in ABS-CBN is prejudiced, and there is absolutely no basis for the cease and desist order. It causes, there is no harm. There is enough authority for NTC to issue the provisional authority. In fact, talking about that, Tony, You know, there is a memorandum order number 0303-2020. This is a memorandum issued by the NTC on March 18, 2020. And it says all existing permits, certificates, licenses, including radio operator certificates to operate radio communication equipment, networks, and facilities, government or private, in various radio services such as but not limited to fixed and land mobile, amateur, aeronautical, maritime, satellite services, special services, issued by the NTC expiring within March 15, 2020 to April 14, 2020, or during the enhanced community quarantine period, shall continue to be valid for 60 days after the end of the government-imposed quarantine period. At its surface, it would appear that everybody, that the licenses issued by the NTC is automatically extended by 60 days if this circular will apply.
Yeah.
And yet, ABS-CBN was single-handedly prohibited from continuing to operate.
Hmm.
My suggestion is that the ABS-CBN should immediately challenge this abuse of discretion on the part of the NTC. You know, they have the authority, but it can be questioned because it is not in accordance with jurisprudence, and it is in grave abuse of discretion, to say the least.
Hmm. Could the Senate also hold the NTC accountable for saying one thing during a hearing and then doing something in actuality, contrary to what its earlier statements were?
Well, we have no. These were opinions issued, legal opinions and positions issued by the NTC. I do not know, Tony, what you mean by we can hold them responsible politically and before the bar of public opinion, we can hold them responsible for it.
Mm.
But beyond that, I do not really know if the Senate can do anything, especially that in this case, the approval of the franchise must originate from the House.
Yeah.
We cannot act on it in the Senate.
That's
so
true.
That's where we stand. So the remedy is to challenge this order before the Supreme Court, and hopefully the Supreme Court will issue a temporary restraining order or TRO because, Tony, no one is prejudiced by the temporary suspension of the cease and desist order. On the other hand, if this is not restrained, it can cause prejudice to the 11,000 employees of ABS-CBN, to say the least. And number two, the general public is deprived of an avenue of information so critical at this time because of the COVID pandemic.
You know, looking at the future, where you know other broadcast institutions or companies might have to also undergo a franchise renewal hearing, do you feel that there should be an overhaul of the system under which these franchises are actually issued?
Certainly. That's one of the areas probably that the Senate Committee of Senator Polk can look into, what safeguards can be installed so that this patent abuse of discretion on the part of NTC will not be repeated.
Mm. All right. Well, Senator Drilon, we appreciate it very much. You're giving us some of your views on this issue, and we'd like to wish you well. Thank you very much, sir, for speaking with us today.
Welcome, Tony.
Let ABS-CBN continue its operations. That pronouncement coming from Gamaliel Cordoba, Commissioner of the National Telecommunications Commission, during the House hearing on the network's franchise issue was last March 10. During the hearing, the lawmakers also asked the National Telecommunications Commission, or NTC, on whether it will issue ABS-CBN a provisional authority to operate, even after its franchise expired on May 4th.
there is sufficient equitable basis to allow broadcast entities to continue operating while the bills for the renewal of their respective franchise remain pending with Congress. However, a more stable legal environment could be created if Congress, by a concurrent resolution, would authorize the NTC to issue a provisional authority to these broadcasting companies. May I assure this committee that barring a gross violation of its franchise of the NTC rules and regulations, the NTC will follow the latest advice of the DOJ and let ABS-CBN continue operations based on equity, Your Honors. We are very comforted by the fact that both chambers of Congress are aligned with the DOJ's and NTC's thinking on the issue.
Meanwhile, another lawmaker weighs in on this development. Senator Kiko Pangilinan joins us now on the line. Senator Pangilinan, magandang hapon sa iyo.
Yeah, magandang hapon, Tony, at kiniki at sa mga nakikinig. Magandang hapon.
Well, we've been talking, of course, about how the NTC said one thing weeks ago in the House, and suddenly pulls this decision on ABS-CBN. And in the intermediate period, what do you think happened? I mean, why should they change position from seeing no hindrance to the grant of a provisional authority to now saying that we have to actually stop operations?
Well, if you ask me, this is plain and simple grave abuse of governmental power. No, it is abusive, it is arbitrary. No less than the NTC has issued hundreds of provisional authorities to hundreds of broadcasting companies throughout the country who have no franchise but whose franchises are pending approval. Mm. So why single out the ABS-CBN? Mm. Ito ay nakakalungkot. Over 10,000 employees of ABS-CBN are now in limbo because of this cease and desist order. Samantala, yung mga POGO operations, pinabubukas. Inuuna pa yung mga Chinese nationals at negosyo nila. At yung mahigit 10,000 natin mga kababayan na ay silang mawalan ng trabaho. Apart from that, of course, is yung malayang pamamahayag. Information is critical during this pandemic. And ABS-CBN, apart from, of course, the other broadcasting companies, GMA7, TV5, are all involved in information dissemination, information that is critical sa panahon ng pandemya. Ba't nila isasara? Information that may save lives. And yet, here they are wanting to close down the TV station. We condemn this act. We believe that it is abusive of this government, the exercise of governmental power. It's arbitrary. And we urge the ABS-CBN to bring this immediately to the Supreme Court. I think that is the quickest remedy. The matter is still pending before the House of Representatives, and I don't know if they'll be able to act on it officially, given, of course, the pandemic, given the crisis that we're facing. So nakakalungkot itong pangyayaring ito. Inuuna pa ang panggigipit, pagsasara ng kumpanya sa harap ng pandemya. 2 milyong kababayan na natin ang nawalan na ng trabaho. Dinadagdagan pa nila. Ano ba ito? Kalukuhan ito.
Kanina, Senator Kiko, tinanong ko lang kay Senator Drilon, if the Senate can do anything to hold the OSG accountable for, its actions, trying to, of course, pressure the NTC, perhaps by threat of penalty if they actually grant a provisional authority to ABS-CBN. Do you think that the Senate should actually take a closer look now at the powers of the OSG and whether or not it overstepped its authority in this case?
Well, that is part of our function as a third branch of government, no? That we will act as a check on the abuses or excesses of the executive department. And therefore, definitely, we should be able to look into this, look into their budget, and also look into how we may be able to address and create a situation to precisely to get them to act in accordance with the law. But that will take time too. Hindi ito kaagad mangyayari.
Yeah.
Dahil nga sa kasalukuyang sitwasyon natin, no? That may require legislation, course preparation of committee report, etc. But immediately, I think the remedy now is immediate relief should be with the courts, with the Supreme Court.
All right. Senator Kiko Pangilinan, thank you very much also for giving us your views on this piece of breaking news.
Thank you. Uulitin ko. Binubuksan nila yung pogo para sa mga Chinese nationals, tapos ipasasara nila ang isang media company na mayroong labing isang libong mga kababayan natin. Mali. Baluktot itong naging pasyon na ito at dapat tutulan at dapat baliktarin ng Korte Suprema hanggat sa lalong madaling panahon. Maraming salamat.
Senator Kiko Pangilinan. I will be speaking now to Nueva Ecija 2nd District Representative Micaela Violago for her views on this development. Congresswoman Violago, magandang hapon po.
Magandang hapon din po.
Ma'am, tama po ba? Kayo din po yung unang nag-file po ng bill for the franchise renewal ng ABS-CBN sa nakaraang Kongreso at ito inirefile nyo rin itong kasalukuyang Kongreso?
Opo. Ako po pareho ang nung 17th Congress.
Opo.
Pinile ko po to and then I refile it ngayon pong 18th Congress.
Sa inyong pananaw po, ahantong pa ho ba sana sa ganitong punto na yung NTC pa mismo ang magpapasara sa ABS-CBN kung inaksyonan na rin po agad sana sa Kamara yung pong mga panukala na na-file nyo na nung 17th o nitong 18th Congress?
Doon nga po ako nagtataka. Kasi po, the NTC committed to the Committee on Franchise po last March 10, 2020. Ito po yung last meeting namin bago magkaroon ng break ang Kongreso na sila po ay magpo-provide ng provisional authority sa ABS-CBN. At ito po ay na-put on the record ng ating committee secretariat. And then, ako po rin ay nagtataka dahil kahit po sa Senate hearing and sa Congress hearing, ay sa kanila po mismo nang gagaling that the ABS-CBN can still operate until year 2022. Ngayon po ako po ay nagtataka bakit bigla sila nagkaroon ng ganitong cease and desist order. Kaya yun nga po ang malaking katanungan sa NTC dahil sila mismo naman ay galing sa kanilang mga bibig na pwedeng mag-operate ang ABS-CBN.
Meron po ba kayong nakikitang sabihin na nating agarang solusyon para medyo maliwanagan po yung NTC sa naging hakbang nilang ito?
Kasi alam naman po natin ngayong panahong ito, nandito tayo sa pandemic ng COVID-19. Ako lamang po ay isang sinasabi ko nga po, author lang ako ng to renew the franchise of ABS-CBN. Pero hindi ko naman po hawak ang sitwasyon kung ano ang magiging desisyon. Pero sa ngayon po kasi lahat tayo ngayon ay nakafocus sa COVID-19. At sana po ang tanging masasabi ko sana sa NTC, sana ay binigyan naman nila ng kahalaga yung ginagawa ng ABS-CBN na mag-ulat o magbalita sa ating mga kababayan tungkol sa kaganapan ng COVID-19. Kasi parang hindi po timely na ngayon mo isasara. Ngayon kailangan natin ng additional kasama para maghatid balita sa ating mga sa ating pong mga tikapakinig o tikapanood ng mga balita.
Ma'am, sa tingin niyo po ba, dahil sinabi naman po ni Speaker Alan Cayetano na sa pananaw niya no, na hindi naman dapat magsara ang ABS-CBN, eh makakakilos pa rin naman po ang Kamara para maibigay rin yung prangkisa na bagong prangkisa ng kumpanya?
Opo, kasi ako po ay naniniwala po ako sa sinasabi ng ating mahal na Speaker Cayetano na maaari pang magpatuloy ang ABS-CBN sa paglabas po ng anumang programa sa telebisyon o sa radyo. Dahil ito, alam ko po na ito rin ang desisyon ng ating mahal na speaker na ipagpatuloy ng ABS ang kanilang mga programa. Kaya, yun nga lang po, dahil alam nyo naman na mayroon tayong pandemic, kami po ay kahit gusto kong pumasok sa Kongreso, eh hindi naman po pwedeng basta na lang kami magsipasukan lahat.
Mm-hmm.
Dahil nga po, alam naman natin naka-ECQ pa ang Maynila.
Opo. Mm-hmm. Ano po ba ang mensahe na gusto niyo pong ipaabot sa mga tao po sa NTC?
Sana po, gusto ko lamang pong ipaabot sa NTC na sana yung sinabi ninyo nung una, eh pinangatawanan ninyo. Di po ba? Kasi sa inyo rin naman nanggaling na pwedeng ipagpatuloy ng ABS-CBN ang kanilang mga programa. Dahil ito po ay sinabi nyo sa Senate hearing, sinabi nyo rin po sa franchise hearing na kayo po mismo ang nagsabi nito. Kaya ako po ay nagtataka kung bakit kayo biglang nagkaroon ng decision ng ganitong klaseng desisyon.
Hmm.
Sana nga po malinawan din ako ng NTC kung bakit sila gumawa ng action na ganito.
Mm-hmm. Sige, maraming salamat po, Congresswoman Villago, sa oras po na ibinigay niyo sa amin.
Maraming salamat din po.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, ma'am.
Po.
Laguna Representative Sol Aragones is urging the NTC to reconsider its position as she admits she was caught by surprise by the NTC's cease and desist order versus ABS-CBN. Aragones, who previously worked with the media network as a journalist, says unemployment is already up due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Despite the order, Aragones says she still hopes the NTC would reverse its decision and issue the media giant a provisional authority to continue operations.
So yung panawagan natin sa NTC, tingnan din ho natin yung kapakanan ng bansa natin ngayon. Marami nang walang trabaho. Yung mga taga-ABS-CBN, umaasa ho sila dito na pagkatapos ng araw ng May 4 kahapon, ay lalabas na ng NTC ang provisional authority para may pagpatuloy nila ang kanilang buhay.
Earlier, National Telecommunications Commission Deputy Commissioner Edgardo Cabarrios had an interview with our correspondent Alvin El Chico, where he talked about the network's franchise issue. Here's that interview.
Kanina, bago ako pumasok, partner, in-interview ko na si NTC Deputy Commissioner Cabarrios. Because sabi ko nga, maraming interesado, Sir Peter, kaya lang hindi natin siya makontakt ngayon. Ipi-play natin yung audio clip. I'm supposed to use it for my story naman sana the next day o sa TV Patrol. Anyway, sige nga po, pakinggan natin yung pahayag at pagpapaliwanag ni NTC Deputy Commissioner Edgardo.
Let's now talk to ABS-CBN correspondent Mike Navalio on what's next for the media giant. Mike?
Hi, Nikki. Justice Secretary Minado Guevara has clarified that the cease and desist order issued by the National Telecommunications Commission against ABS-CBN is immediately executory, which means that ABS-CBN has to comply and go off air before it could get any... But it could still appeal the cease and desist order or avail of some remedy from the court while this cease and desist order is in effect. Guevara was asked for his opinion or his reaction to the NTC's issuance of that cease and desist order, considering that he earlier said that broadcast companies who are renewing their license with Congress are still or should still be allowed to continue their operations. In a statement, Guevara said that the NTC requested our opinion and the DOJ gave them an advice in accordance with law and equity. The Congress expressed essentially the same view as that of the DOJ and further enjoined the NTC to issue a provisional authority to ABS-CBN. The NTC issued a cease and desist order instead. It must have a very good reason for doing so. Let's wait for the explanation. And a follow-up message, he said that a CDO is immediately executory but still appealable to the court. So we're waiting, Nikki, for word from our management as to the next steps that will be taken. We understand that there are several remedies that could be taken, including asking for a status quo an order or a TRO from the court preventing the immediate execution or immediate implementation of the cease and desist order coming from the NTC. Okay?
Thanks for that update, Mike. Let's hope for what's right. Let's hope for what's best. Earlier, National Telecommunications Commission Deputy Commissioner Edgardo Cabarrios had an interview with our correspondent Alvin El Chico where he talked about the network's franchise issue. Here's that interview again.
Kanina, bago ako pumasok, partner, in-interview ko na si NTC Deputy Commissioner Cabarrios. Because sabi ko nga, maraming interesado, Sir Peter, eh, kailang hindi natin siya makontakt ngayon, ipi-play natin yung audio clip. I'm supposed to use it for my story naman sana sa the next TV day Patrol. O sa TV Patrol. Anyway, sige nga po, pakinggan natin yung pahayag at pagpapaliwanag ni NTC Deputy Commissioner Edgardo Cabarrios.
Okay, go ahead.
Ano naman legal remedies ay available?
Hindi, pero until ma-issue yung TRO, ano mayayari sa amin?
Immediate Secretary, yung order, no? Well, hindi ko lang alam whether a motion for recon, kasi may Marian, will stay the order, no? Habang may MR siya.
Who can answer that?
Lawyer. Lawyer, no?
Hindi, pero ibig sabihin, i-implement nyo ba kaagad yung CDO sa amin? Or ibig sabihin, pwede pa kaming, hayaan nyo muna kaming mag-file ng motion for reconsideration or go to the Supreme Court bago kami ipasara?
Well, MR, hindi ko, kung ano, kasi may mga instances naman yata in the past na pagka may MR, mag-rurun muna doon sa MR.
So ibig mo sabihin, sir, pwede pa kami umere ngayon.
I'm not sure, no? Kasi, I'm not sure kasi hindi ako lawyer.
Hindi, pero dapat lang ako po kasi kayo sa NTC. I mean, di ba?
Yes. All of this kasi were based from analysis and findings of our legal team. So, yan. Although ang NTC, the quasi-judicial body, yung decision is immediate executory. Lahat ng quasi-judicial bodies, yung immediate executory, no? Pero yung MR, I'm not quite sure. Baka hindi, because of the MR, yung immediate executory niya, baka ma-delay. I'm not quite sure.
Pero ngayon, halimbawa ngayon, magti-TV patrol. Ang ibig mo bang sabihin kung immediately executory, wala ng broadcast ngayon dahil nailabas na yung order? O pwedeng magtuloy-tuloy pa rin yung broadcast namin?
Well, as I've said, yung pag-aralan mabuti ng legal team nyo. Kung ano yung the best approach sa issue.
Opo. So kasi ang mga empleyado actually aligaga, ano? Ang tanong lang naman kasi hindi naman sila abogado kagaya mo, kagaya ko, ano po. Ang tanong lang is, titigil ba kami sa pagtatrabaho ngayon? Titigil ba yung airing ngayon o hindi?
Ang sabi ko nga is may mga available legal remedies para for you to continue on air, no? So, pag-aralan mabuti ng legal team. And file necessary.
Ibig mo sabihin, pag nag-file sila ngayon, hindi na rin ma-actionan kasi mag-aalas 5 na.
Yun ang hindi ko kabisado, no? We refer natin sa ating legal team.
Sinasakot ng order nyo? Channel 2, DZMM, and ANC, o Channel 2 lang?
ABS-CBN.
So, which includes what?
Lahat ng istasyon ng ABS-CBN.
Including ANC?
Hindi. ANC is not con. ANC kasi is content eh.
So, DZMM
lang? It is the station. Yun ang mga istasyon.
Oh,
hindi yung content. Hindi yung content, ano? Content, hindi kasama yung content. It is the stations.
Oo nga, sir. Pero
yung mga radio stations.
So, DZMM kasali?
Well, the radio station DZMMVS, but not the content. Hindi yung laman nun.
Ano ibig sabihin nun? So, paano niya mabobroadcast yung laman niya kung wala siyang airwaves?
Eh, pwede sa iba. You can make use online, whatever platform, pwede. No?
But not the airwaves.
But ang covered lang yan is the airwave, yes.
Yung airwave?
Kasi radio control lo yun.
So, ibig sabihin siya pati yung airwaves ng ANC sako? Kasi ang ANC also uses airwaves.
Cable? Hindi. ANC is content eh.
So, cable yun?
ANC is content. Pinapadaan lang yung content sa istasyon ng ABS-CBN.
Kaya nga, so saan niya ipadadaan yun? Kung may content siya?
Pwede sa iba.
Sa online?
Pwede sa ibang platform.
Okay. Naku sir, aligaga, sinasabi ko sa iyo, lahat ng tao, binaba yung lahat ng ginagawa nila. Kasi yun lang naman ang tanong, titigil ba? O pwede pang may remedyo pa, tatakbo kami sa korte?
May legal remedy yan. I am quite sure may legal remedy yan.
Oo. Pero wala, pero sa ngayon, wala kami magagawa kung dito stop.
Again, pwede pag-aralan kasi ng legal team nyo. And they will advise you whether to continue or to stop.
And we're getting more reactions to the NTC cease and desist order against ABS-CBN Corporation. Senator Sonny Angara joins us now on the line. Senator Angara, good afternoon to you.
Hi, Tony. Good afternoon. And to all the viewers, good afternoon then.
Well, you've heard that exchange between our anchor, Alvin El Chico, and NTC Deputy Commissioner Edgardo Cabarrios. Does the NTC explanation sound clear to you?
Well, I came in midstream, Tony, so I didn't hear the whole thing. I just overheard him telling Alvin, for the most part, to consult his lawyers, or ABS, to consult their lawyers. Mm. But I heard him say that about 3 times.
Now, we've had other lawmakers already weigh in on this issue, and many of them hark back to the March hearing at the House, where the NTC already gave its opinion that there should really be no impediment to granting ABS-CBN a provisional authority to operate. I believe the same question was asked of the NTC during the Senate hearing. So what do you make of it? Why the NTC would suddenly flip and not push through with, you know, its original intention to grant that provisional authority?
Yeah, it's puzzling to me, Tony, because we were talking with our colleagues during the session, towards the tail end of today's legislative session in the Senate. We brought it up that we got the news that the NTC issued this order, and it surprised us because the last time before we adjourned, we had already, along with the House, passed resolutions expressing our sense that that the NTC can allow ABS to operate pending the discussion on its franchise, on the renewal of its franchise. And the same opinion was given by the Department of Justice to Secretary Guevara. So it's quite surprising to that the NTC has decided in this manner. And Senator Majority Leader Zubiri, who used to chair the Committee on Franchises, mentioned that it's quite ordinary practice for the NTC to issue provisional authority. So this case is somewhat exceptional in sense.
Do you see any ulterior motives on the part of the NTC in doing this?
I don't want to delve into that, Tony. You know, that would be speculative on my part. There's no evidence of that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that let's just talk about the effects. You know, the economy is going to go south because of the worldwide economic crisis. You know, two biggest economies are already feeling it: the U.S. and China. And that's going to have ripple effects on the Philippines. You know, there will be companies closing up. And here is the government closing one of the companies who has not been really asking for help from the government and has been paying their employees. That's the number one, no? yung effect on the families. You're talking about thousands of families and thousands of people supporting who are depending on this industry. You're not just talking about the direct employees of the company, but you're also talking about the freelancers, the ones who make the videos or who make the music, mm-hmm. or, you know, all of these graphics, for instance. Mm-hmm. These are not all, a lot of this is outsourced, to my understanding, to my knowledge, Tony. No? And secondly, legally, as I said earlier, it's quite exceptional because it goes against the grain of what Congress has asked the NTC to do, and it goes against the grain of what of the opinion of the Department of Justice, which is the lawyer of the government. So it's truly a curious, exceptional case. There's more than meets the eye, it seems, no? Mm-hmm. More to it than meets the eye.
Mm-hmm.
And also, thirdly, and I think this is probably the thing that would be felt by our countrymen or our kababayan, if we need reliable information in this day and age. There's so much fake news going around online. There are so many spam texts. There are hoaxes. There are people trying to take advantage of people with scams online. So, you know, ABS-CBN, if you go to the provinces, it's really one of those with its strong signal. I think if you go to the Visayas and Mindanao, it's really one of those relied upon by people who live sa bundok, sa malalayong barangay, in the far-flung barangay. So it's a shame to be depriving them of this source of information, you know, which is very much needed in this time when you need people to kind of you need the accurate information being disseminated, what to do, how to avoid being infected, how to stay healthy, things like that. No? So those are, I think, the three comments I'd make about the situation.
And you do remember the newly reinstalled presidential spokesperson, Harry Roque, recently saying that the Solicitor General is the alter ego of the president. But in this context, after the executives of ABS-CBN, through Carlo Katigbak, had issued an apology for perhaps maybe, if the president had felt slighted by ABS-CBN's actions during the presidential campaign, and the president having accepted the apology, that the relationship between Malacañang with ABS-CBN should have already been smoothed over, that the alter ego of the president would have taken his cue from that. But given with this development, he's still threatening the NTC and the DOJ with legal action if they actually did issue that provisional authority to ABS-CBN. What do you make of that? That the OSG is threatening the NTC and the DOJ?
It's a curious action, given that the DOJ is the one who issued the opinion on this. And it's a sound legal opinion if you listen to it, because there's really no law which disallows or allows a provisional authority. So equity comes into play, and the practice or how the actors have interpreted the law in the past. So I guess the remedy is either in the Supreme Court or for Congress to act on the franchise. These are two possible remedies for ABS-CBN.
Of course, it's I guess you've already admitted in the past, in other interviews, that you do have a personal connection to ABS-CBN, right?
Yes. My wife has been working there for over 20 years.
Yes. So
I disclosed that during the Senate committee hearing.
That's true. Yeah. All right. Well, I guess you also have a lot to talk about in your home, especially now that a member of your family is also directly affected by this development. Thank you very much, Senator Sani Angara.
Yes, I sympathize with you guys, Tony. I wish you the best.
Well, the fight isn't over yet, Senator.
I'm sure.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
All right, our next guest describes the NTC cease and desist order against ABS-CBN, a blatant disregard of the constitutional authority and prerogative of Congress on legislative franchises. We'll be speaking now to Agusan del Norte, 1st District Representative Lawrence Fortun. Congressman Fortun, magandang hapon po sa inyo. Magandang gabi po.
Magandang gabi po, Tony. Magandang gabi sa inyong listeners.
Yeah. Well, how did you react, first of all, to hearing the decision of the NTC to issue that cease and desist order?
Well, Tony, I'm very, very sad. I'm by this turn of events because the NTC had categorically made a commitment to the House of Representatives when it appeared before the Committee on Legislative Franchises last March. The NTC, through its chair, said that if there is clear and categorical advice from the House of Representatives, they would issue the corresponding provisional permit. And we are surprised that suddenly, today, they issued a cease and desist order.
Hmm. Well, given that, you know, many suggestions are that the next course of action, at least, would be to ask the Supreme Court to step in and issue a restraining order, do you think that that would actually help at this point?
Well, that can be one of the legal remedies that ABS-CBN can resort to. Seek the intervention of the Supreme Court, get a TRO to restrain the NTC from implementing its order. But I think we can appeal also to the NTC to reconsider its order because for us, Tony, this is a grave affront to both houses of Congress. That NTC did not make a commitment, to the House of Representatives only, but also to the Senate. So to both houses, no, of Congress, which is the branch of government that ultimately has the power to issue and revoke franchises. Mm-hmm. And I do not see any reason why suddenly NTC retracts, no? Mm-hmm. Suddenly makes a turnaround, at hindi na sinunod yung kanyang commitment.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, this will go down in history as the worst action this agency has in wanton disregard not only of the expressed intent of Congress, but also the impact of its action on press freedom and the plight of thousands of workers, and especially that it happened in this time of great crisis that the country is facing.
Mm. You know, given that you're pointing out how you feel the NTC, you know, may have at least disregarded the authority of Congress, do you feel that they should be held accountable or responsible for their actions, that that Congress should actually look at possible sanctions against them?
Yes, Tony, definitely. In fact, the NTC is in contempt sa ginawa nila, no? And I, for one, would demand that the NTC be made to appear before the House of Representatives and explain to us why suddenly they reneged, no, and on their commitment.
Mm.
Klarong-klaro yung commitment na ginawa nila doon sa amin sa Committee on Legislative Franchises at saka sa Senado.
Mm.
Ang sabi lang nila, if there is a clear and categorical official advice from the Senate and the House of Representatives that it is the intent of Congress to allow provisional operation in the meantime that the renewal of franchises are the renewal are still being heard by the House, bibigyan nila ng provisional authority. And
yeah,
suddenly, ito yung nangyari, no? And I think also, Tony, aside from the resort to the Supreme Court, maybe Congress can already hear the bills out, no,
yeah,
right away.
Mm-hmm.
And because if Congress ultimately passes the necessary legislation giving franchise to ABS-CBN, then the NTC can't anymore do anything about it.
Mm.
And that's the cease and desist order to be lifted right away as soon as Congress passes the necessary law granting ABS-CBN legislative franchise.
Hey, do you think, Congressman Fortune, that the process at the House would still take up time? Or would this action by the NTC actually help to expedite the hearing at the House Committee on Legislative Franchises?
It should help matters to be expedited, Tony. No? In fact, this is a lesson learned for the House of Representatives because whether we like it or not, no, we know that the committee also dilly-dallied. No?
had the committee immediately acted on this on the franchise bills and passed the necessary legislation early on, this would not have reached this point, no, naaabutin ng expiration of the franchise. So effectively, parang we abdicated our power and nilipat namin sa kamay ng NTC ang pagbibigay ng authority to operate further, no, after May 4. But then again, that's water under the bridge. What we can do now is expedite our proceedings, expedite our action, and pass the necessary legislation immediately so that the Senate can also act on it when it is transmitted to the Senate.
All right, Congressman Lawrence Fortun, thank you very much for giving us your views on this development. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, Tony.
And now Albay First District Representative Ed Salugman joins us on this part of our special coverage. Congressman Lagman, magandang gabi po sa inyo.
Magandang gabi, Sis Tony.
Yes, Tony Velasquez po, kasama si Nikki De Guzman.
Well, Tony, we have not been in contact for some time.
That's right, sir. And we'd like to appreciate, of course, your time to give us your views on this breaking news development. Well, in your view, how could the NTC have missed out on the opportunity to make good on its word that it gave to the House that it could issue a provisional authority?
Well, I have repeatedly underscored, Tony, that there is no other solution to the dilemma of ABS-CBN than the seasonable extension of its legislative franchise prior to its expiration. I think now the action of the NTC issuing the cease and desist order against ABS-CBN's nationwide operation is a confirmation of an apparent charade between the House leadership and the NTC chairman, commissioner. Because you will recall that the House Speaker and Chairman Alvarez wrote NTC that the latter should issue a provisional authority after the expiration of the legislative franchise and during the first and only public hearing on the franchise, Commissioner Cordoba explicitly admitted and undertook that such provisional authority will be issued. Now, what happened? He did that because even the Executive Department through the Solicitor General has objected to said solution because it's not consistent with the law and jurisprudence. We will recall that Section 15 of Republic Act 7925 says categorically, and I quote, "No person shall commence or conduct the business of being a public telecommunication entity without first obtaining a franchise." Hello?
Yes, sir. I'm still here.
Yeah. And then there is also the jurisprudence in the ruling of the Supreme Court in Associated Communications and Wireless Service United Broadcasting Networks versus NTC, the Supreme Court said, quote, "As long as the law remains unchanged, the requirement of a franchise to operate a television station must be upheld." So I have explained this over and over again, that provisional authority is not a solution. But anyway, not everything is lost.
Yes, sir.
Because the House and the Senate are now in session, and I think the leadership of the House can prioritize the enactment of a bill extending or renewing the franchise, considering that it has been long pending and there is no formal and credible opposition to such renewal.
Well,
and I think we should really avert this situation when the cessation of operation of ABS-CBN is sounding the death knell of the freedom of the press, even as thousands of employees and indirect workers and enterprises dependent on the broadcasting network are doomed to lose their livelihood. Moreover, the stoppage of the ABS-CBN's operation is even more tragic because the public now needs and depends on the broadcast information more than ever as COVID-19 continues to rampage.
Congressman Edsel, you know, here's a thought, and I hope you can indulge me on this. You know, a lot of people, I guess, would look at the you know, the story behind the ABS-CBN franchise renewal, starting with the grievances of President Duterte against the company, and somehow, you know, other lawmakers took the cue from it and delayed the passage of a new franchise for ABS-CBN. Do you think at this juncture it would again take the president himself to direct the NTC to reverse its position and actually tell it to issue that provisional authority?
No way, no way. Because the NTC, pursuant to the existing law and jurisprudence, has no authority to extend a provisional franchise to a TV network whose franchise has already expired and has not been renewed.
Right. So
the only solution is to act now, to immediately and forthwith grant the renewal, because as I have said, there is no formal opposition, there is no credible opposition, and that is, it has long been pending.
Well, I hope you and your colleagues at the House of Representatives do, in fact, get the process rolling.
I hope our colleagues, the membership, will do that. But we are waiting for the leadership of the House to initiate the process in dispatch.
Do you think you'll be hearing from the House leadership tonight?
Well, I hope so. We have been trying to tell the House leadership to act soonest, but they waited too long, and now we have a bigger problem.
All right. Congressman Edsel Agman, good to hear from you again, and hopefully we will be hearing from each other again over this channel.
Yes, Tony, because I'm sure you will be able to get your renewal.
Thank you for your optimism, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tony.
ABS-CBN will cease and desist operations tonight. That's according to the network in compliance with the latest order issued by the National Telecommunications Commission. ABS-CBN adds it needs enough time to properly shut down its equipment and tell its audience about this latest development. And that's what we have for today. I'm Nikki de Guzman.
And I'm Tony Velasquez. Keep it here on ANC. We will simulcast TV Patrol when it comes in after the show and until ABS-CBN Free TV signs off at 7 p.m. ANC is not covered by the order of the National Telecommunications Commission, and we will continue to go on air.